All right. Hello, everyone. We're back. We're getting into it. Round two for today of working on this avatar. So let's make the eyelashes. And then we'll finish the hair and the mask. Eyelashes, hair, mask. For the eyelashes, let's actually crease this all the way. So it needs a little bit of a vertex crease so we can actually should be able to do this if I just grab both of them. I know that's really hard to see. If I just grab both of them and crease it like that. All right. Now I can get that shape that I want.
You sure?
Yeah, what's that?
Sorry, real quick. For a second.
Yeah. All right, I'm back. Move that up. Just trying to even out the space of these vertices. That looks pretty good. Now what we'll do is we'll add one here. And then close it as far as we can go, crease it, then kind of push it back. This one top left corner is looking kind of odd. I think I have to crease it like that. That's the only way these corners are going to work properly. All right, but now we have the beginning stages of that eyelash. So it's a straight line on the top and then a ha curve halfway down. Thankfully, it's very flush with the eye. So that does make it a little bit easier to get the positioning correct. Something kind of like that. Grab that. Should I decrease? Huh, decrease. Interesting. There's crease, increase, decrease. Is crease? Wonder what crease used to mean. I feel like it must have meant something different past. Interesting. But unnecessary information for right now. So we'll do that. We'll take these faces here and just extrude them little bit more. Right there. A little bit thicker. So we go back. Around there. Okay. And then these corner ones crease all the way. And we've got a nice little line. Think on this side, I will just extrude it a little bit more. Okay, push it out. Go to normal. SZ0. Extrude. It's not worth it. one. Off. All right. All right, I like that geometry. It's a little funky right here. I think for this spot decrease. See, that phrase kind of throws me off. Decrease. Because it's like, there's increase, as in to increase something, decrease, lower the count, but crease itself, does that refer, or did it refer in the past to something numerical? If so, that is news to me. Yeah, this straighter. I can't. Well, if I want it perfectly straight, I can take all of this here, go to normal, SZ0, then do the same for the top. And now that should be perfectly straightened. Trying to even out the spacing of perfect. Maybe a little bit more straight. This angle's more severe than it is right here, so let's. But it's easy to fix because we just grab that whole thing. Much better. A little bit more. Just slightly. Now we do the bottom. So it's about just a lower section. Increase that, increase it even more. Should basically be this middle point here. I think we can just move this over a little. That's already in a pretty good spot. Maybe down a little bit on that side. Okay, so like this. So let's manually move it. Manually. All right, and now here it's a little, it's much thicker. Here, these three. One, two, three. Extrude. And crease. Getting odd right there. I think we need to throw one cut here. How many edges is this? That's not helpful. Has to be even. Should mean that there's a crease. One, two, three, four. Crease. So ideally, this corner should have been here. I should have extruded this edge. All right, let's do that. So, easy fix, thankfully. Boom, one. And then we will take this edge, this one. Decrease. Is that word again? And move it over like that. All right. So, what is going on there? I need to definitely need to crease the spot. And there's some sort of folding happening there. It's this point. So we'll take that, move it over. All right, should fix that. Then we now have our side crease. So the halfway point on the eye. All right. looking very boxy right now. This looks really stretched right there. Not necessarily. I think the interior side is looking pretty good, but we just need to make this exterior side also look a little nicer, just a little curved like that. Muyoko XD, dreamed drink water. Agua time. Thank you. I'm now more hydrated. Hope you're doing well. Thanks for coming by earlier. And thanks for coming back. Something like that. All right, that spacing looks good. Just a little bit further in there. Didn't have to go much farther. But that definitely feels like eyelash is perfect. All we want to do now is just cement this crease. We could even mark it sharp like that, and we get an actual crease. But I should probably do that with a normal map instead of the normals themselves. All right, switch that in. Dope. All right, time for the hair. So we already started the hair. Actually, a few things first. We're going to take the mask and add those to Pix clothes. And this one is closed. Yep. And now we'll focus on just the hair. So we've already got kind of this little shape. We've got a few smaller chunks. I think we'll want to do something like one on the far side here. There. There. Let's see. There. one here. Sure. All right. All right. Let's finish the general shape of the back. Boom. Boom. All right. So now we've ripped off the back pieces. And we can start on these shapes. So the hair kind of has this taper like that. A little bit on that side too. So take this, go like that, this, and like that. A little bit more here too. Perfect. Dissolve. Boom. All right. Let's do a cut down the middle. Excuse me. Connect this side to that side. So the back from the side also has this kind of taper look like that. Decent. The one unknown is this side here. Don't quite have a good understanding of what should be there, but we can certainly improvise. So we'll do that now. Boom. Boom. rip there. This one in the middle. Let's see if that's how I really want to do it, but for now, we've committed. Definitely a little more fluff there, there, and there. But I think first things first, let's combine these two objects. Well, actually, before we do that, let's actually finish the back of the hair. So basically, what we're going to do is extrude this inward, and then that. Now we have these chunks that we need to fill in. Chunks. Chunky. All right, perfect. We've created the back. Sorry, not perfect. Let's fill this in first. Before. Doop, doop. Right, easy. 0.860. And then boom. right. Now we can apply that. Actually, let's make a backup copy. Picks of V1. Work in progress. Creamy hair. Okay. Now we can apply them. Then combine them with hair. Mirror hair. There we go. Crease this one too. And we're just trying to give some form, some variation to the hair streaks, strokes, tufts. We just duplicate this. Move this one in. Probably a more elegant way to do that. Let's actually rip this one too. Next, duplicate this one. Yeah, that works. Okay. Now, as a whole, looking pretty good. Kind of reminds me of ice cream. Excuse me. Now. Already so close to the max limit. That's not a max limit. Need this. Gotta watch out for that. It's poking through the back of the ear. Actually, let's do a cut. And then because I like the placement of the hair here. I don't want to change that too much. Now the tufts don't quite go as low as I have them. All right, improvement. Now on this side of the hair, we want to take these two pieces and extrude them. Grease this one. And crease that one. All right, now that we've done that, I would like to make some sort of hairline, kind of like this. Big Poop, hello. I have once again bought another game, but one I cannot stop playing. Oh, Factorio. Now you like shooters. Also, welcome. Hello, Big Poop. Oh, heck yeah. That seems like a fun one. Watched a few streamers play through it. I don't think I personally have enough patience for it, but I definitely understand the appeal. Change something about your camera. I did make my stream lower resolution, but I don't think I changed anything about the camera itself. It's a little sunnier today, or brighter. Actually, it's overcast, but it provides a very even light. All right, let's get this little tuft made. This little guy right here. This. It does go down all the way to the eye. Tarkov has made me change a lot of my NVIDIA settings. So right now, my whole PC is like super, super bright now. So you can see easier in the dark. You're literally pale white. Well, that's generally my color. Generally, how I'm considered to be. I don't know about pale, but the lighting is kind of white right now. It's been rainy and overcast all day. I think that's okay. Now, the only way I know you are here is because your hair, otherwise you blend in with the walls because it's so bright. I think that's on your end then. if you can't see me, then that's not, I don't think that's my my setting set. Okay, so we're gonna put a little chunk of fluff right here. Yeah, there. And dissolve that edge. Boom, boom. So one chunk in. One chunk! But yeah, we're doing a lot more commissions this week. Kind of the world building stuff. We'll come back to it at some point, but for now we're taking a break from it. Yeah, that looks super on point, actually. Also make a collection for the mask. I'm going to take these objects and move them into the mask so I can hide it. We got one more strand of hair right here. Do that on the front. Right here. Here. Is that a little too? No, we want it more in the front. What is going on right here? This one I got, it's kind of collapsed in on itself. Ay, ay, ay. Just remembering stupid stuff. I hate that my brain does that. Hey, you want to think about this stressful thing? Guess what? Now you are. Anyway, two more outs. Just gonna go to the eyeball. And mark this sharp so I can kind of get an idea of where the iris is gonna go. Now we have this little tuft here. If we do one more tuft, we combine this tuft and this one. So these will be the same tuft of Rooney's. An interesting spot. Gonna have to reuse some topology here in order to make that happen. Back to being square. Is this square though? 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, that's 4. Okay. Let's give it a shot. Needs to be further back. So these two. Okay, and one last set of tufts here on the back. We want something like so face extrude individual. No. Not individual, extrude faces along normals. Then we'll dissolve this top edge. And then I think we want to some of these will treat as kind of their own tufts. That's better. Better than these ones I don't really like. These two, better, they just need to be brought in a little bit. It kind of reminds me of, what's that character, Steve, from Stranger Things? Just the hair. I'm going to delete this little worm here. Redo that a little bit better. But we do want to make the you know, that thing. End of the hair. All right. So, did that because now the hair actually curls this way. More natural topology. be a little bit too strong on this. A little bit of a crease, or like hairline, but not a full hairline. Oh, babe. Make these that are here. A little bit more stylized than it is right now. So like that works well. It's okay if the nose pokes through a little bit, as we can adjust the body afterwards. We do have a strap coming from the mask right here. I think we'll sculpt rest. Then let's finish the vest. We will go ahead and apply the mirror. I'm always hesitant to apply a mirror because it's like. Just so I want to do work that I can't recover or edit easily, but it's probably worth doing. Just the last thing we'll do is kind of give a nicer slip here. I guess we do that. See this? this there, enter, and this there, enter. Then it zags in, something like that, and it zags out, something like that. And we can take this portion and extrude it. Then we simply grease the important parts. And dissolve. All right, so now we have a few spots that have more than four vertices. I want to find those in. Done. All right, next, take this portion, extrude it, actually crease it, bada boom, and FI. Like so. These spots do need an increase for any odd folding. Right. Lastly, the collar here. Going to duplicate and move up. Then we can simply get the edges, cube, bridge. Bridge. There we are. All right. So that the clothing item is finished. No, it's not. We need these little buttons in the pocket. So there is a pocket right here. First, crease it. It's a pretty small pocket. Oh, damn. Really needed to sneeze right there. That's why it had a vertex crease on it. All right. It's looking really good. Bum bum bum. Bum bum bum. All right, all right, all right. So quiet. I thought I had muted you for a second. Yeah. Well, the longer the day goes on, the harder or the quieter I get. This is like my slump time. I just get very tired around 3 p.m. or so, and I always kind of have to just slog through it. All right, let's make these straps. So these areas here, these little thigh belts, are thinner. Right about there. And they have a little strap on them. Go ahead and make that. It's a circle. Like this. And we'll do a mirror the opposite direction, like that. And then I should have actually done a simpler circle. Like that. And around there. All right, that's better. Take these dots, duplicate them, fill them, move them in. Then extrude. And extrude. And subdivide. And it's nice that we have it here, because then I can rotate it. Right. Oh, I do need to make the shirt too for our fest. Okay, I have to remember to do that. That's the most likely thing for me to forget right now. Bag as well. Something like this.
Dum-dum-dum.
Excuse me. Then last lastly, we have this ribbon here. I like how thin it is, though. I'd rather make the pants. This mirror. Do-do-do-do. I'm going to go grab a snack. Be right back. I'm going to go to the restroom as well. I'll be back real fast. All right, I'm back again. Redeem Inkwatch. Here we go. I also got some Hostess chocolate. All right, so let's start making the armor too. So we'll just take all this. duplicate it, separate it. And then we can turn off the mirror. All right. Let's get the mirror off for right now. But this is going to be our robo arm. Arms in the right spot. And we have this reference here. So I think we'll just close this here. Let's close the end of it. Bada boom. So we capped the arm, and then at the elbow, it's basically segmented on both sides. So we can just delete this elbow. Actually, first, let's just dissolve our little extra points. Boom. And then boom. Okay. So now I think we have some nice sections here. Put a cursor there and ship a. The reason I'm using a cube is it will have just a little bit better topology and resolution than a UV sphere. I'll put one here too. All right, there's the start of our robo arm. So I usually have this here to kind of mimic a tricep, but it seems more mechanical than that. So it goes something like this. I think what we need to do can I do a grid fill on top of this? Whatever, doesn't matter. Boom and boom. There we it's going to look something. opponent saves. So it looks like there's something inside of them. So we'll mess around with it more later, but that should be a pretty doable effect. Move the mic a little closer to me so I don't have to talk quite as loud. And yeah, let's take a look at the boy. Pretty good. Pretty good. Now the fingers look pretty seamless here. Just a few little not like that'll probably we'll just do with the texture. But I would like to get rid of the fingernails. Perfect. All right. Then we'll do this thing again. F-I, crease, extrude, shrink, I, extrude, shrink. There we go. Now we've got these sockets. And then we want a curve. Now our sleeve here is not up high enough. I think I need to move the elbows down. Yeah, the forearm is definitely longer than the upper arm. Kind of just measure it out really quick. Here to here to here. Yeah. Very clearly longer. So what we'll do is grab this, do O, oops, G. And we're just going to kind of squish it over here. Grab out. Doop, doop, doop. All right. That might work. Then these two are going to be interesting. So we'll grab the ball. We'll say connected. And then we'll line it with that same there. That should work pretty darn well, honestly. We'll need to do some rearranging there, so put our cursor there, grab these bones, point 6RZ. Just connect it this time. And just push it. Boom. All right, that works. Then back to our curve. Yeah, that looks good. And then let's turn off the reference. Yeah. Oh. Pretty darn cool.
camera. I wish I could delete something from a mirror modifier beforehand, but I don't think that's possible. Pull that out a little bit so he doesn't look quite as emaciated. But I will need to apply the body modifier sooner rather than later because I need to create Man, why did I copy them? It doesn't matter. But yeah, I do need to apply the mirror mod for the body right now. And boom, boom. That looks kind of cool. Do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do. This goes down to just above the spot right here. Something like that.
It's 4:30 already. I was just complaining about how much time there is, and
then we're already here. Dang, time goes quick. Let's go ahead and turn on smooth. Bring that back. Fill it in. And then we need to crease this one. But now we have a little chin we can work with. And yeah, let's go ahead and crease that to 6SX. Nice, that looks super good. All right, there also is this little panel right here. Slap a subdiv on there. That, right? Let's make sure this is gridded. Hit it with the gritty. Forgetting. Water, bread. All right, let's fill this in. for the chin. Ah, 15 minutes. The countdown until I end the stream. Thanks everyone for hanging out with me today. It's been a good day. Need to kind of close this. It's a gas mask, so it needs some sort of like seam or what is the word for that? A valve, I guess? When it is like a seal? A seal. Also very apt word. All right, there we go. Filled in the back of a mask, which is good. Should prevent any technically we didn't need to do that, but I feel like it's important. Because I want to add a seal to the side of it, because it's supposed to be a gas mask. So we'll do something like that, and then just extrude that out. That'll be our seal. Shit. Oh wait, no, that's working. And shit. All right, now we have an actual seal on the object. We can do something like Alt-S. And I'll make it like a rubber kind of gasket looking thing. I think that'll look pretty cool. Though I don't need it on the inside, just the outside. Otherwise, it'll be a little bit too expensive. In fact, I already have these. Actually, no, this is only at one subdivision. This is at two. It could go up one more. Yeah, that's probably correct for that piece. All right, let's run a cut along there. Almost done for today. Need to review the reference for that bag. So, a little vague. It's more like a satchel or fanny pack. Kind of wraps around the leg a little bit. How tall is it? It doesn't go higher than the hip, so I think we need to delete that part. Move this down. Move this in. Actually, all the faces on here. About there. And then I see. Let's back up one more. I need to work out. I feel my body getting too tense sitting for so long. Never a good feeling. Yeah, I gotta go work out after this. Got to. Really should have gotten a different reference for that, like a picked an actual bag IRL for that, because when it comes to texturing, I'm not gonna be entirely sure what to do about it, but that's all right. I think what we've got left, we're just gonna start making notes for tomorrow. We got the shoelaces. Change this to red. Is it so hard to see? There, terrible purple, but noticeable. So we got the purple. We got the shoelaces. We need to finish the bag. We need to add some wrinkles here. A few spots there. And then mask and oh, the strings. Gotcha. That should be about it. All right. Perfect. So thank you, everyone. Thank you, Muyoko, XD, and Big Poop, and Pixel. Thank you all for coming by today, hanging out with me. It's been a good day, a productive day, which is always nice. Thankfully, we're coming to an end. I get some rest, and I hope you all do the same as well. I'll be back tomorrow, 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. Central, every day. Well, every weekday. But I'll see you then. Thank you again for coming by. Enjoy your day. Bye.